I wanted you to bring people up to date on the research you were doing on these amazing humanoid remains that you've been looking into in Europe that you found.
Well, I finally found a crew that'll follow me there, because I promised the people in Sardinia, near Cagliari, Sardinia, that I would do
right.
something. There are people that own land there. There are farmers and people that have, you know, manor houses and so forth that have these tombs on their land. And what they've done is they've dug them up themselves, and they find these femurs and these teeth and these bones, and you know, formal archaeology doesn't know where to place that. They don't even want to talk about it. And the people and these skeletons of these people are 15 foot tall. They're people that maybe in ancient times we used to call the Titans.
Right.
You know, because mythology has a lot of truth in it. And when I used to teach ancient history in Rome, in Italy, I realized that a lot of what we thought was mythology was just ET intervention, were peoples that were coming to these different countries like Greece, like ancient Mesopotamia, also in the Mediterranean. And so, you know, this one particular man, Luigi Muscas, has written three books and has all kinds of photos of what he's found in his own property. And there's pictures of me with this big tooth. It is not a bovine tooth. It is not an animal tooth. It is a human tooth. And he has a jaw. He has a femur. And the thing that's amazing, even though he has archaeological remains and artifacts, which could belong to, you know, the people that study ancient aliens, what he tells me is that they do come back. And when I ask him what he's talking about, he said, well, you know, at night we sit around and look at the skies, and we see coming from the sky these blue tubes, blue lights. And he says there's people that come down on this land in these blue lights. He said we could see them. We can
right.
see that they still walk among us.
That's exactly right. We've had this happen at Shasta, and some of them – we were told were from the Arcturan star system, and they were like that. They were 12 to 15 feet tall, and we actually have some where they're not fully quite materialized, but these huge, tall, humanoid-shaped beings that are right up against this massive log house at Mount Shasta, and it had to be at least 15 feet tall.
Well, that's amazing, and the more you collect this, the more someday in the near future they'll put two and two together, and they'll realize that we've been visiting, because you have the photos that you do, and you're still doing them, aren't you? You're still doing a lot of photography.
Oh, yes. And see, the thing is that one of the whole areas that we're trying to explore is transdimensional photography, where if an ET being is not fully materialized but has gone from one star system to this one and hasn't phased in to the, but you can begin to see them. We've learned that we can photograph them. People say, well, why don't they just completely materialize? I said, well, because it can be very dangerous. I mean, that craft that materialized and came over us in Crestone 11 months ago immediately had jet fighters on their tail, no doubt with orders to shoot to kill. So what we find is that we'll often have these contact experiences, and we are getting photographs of them. And in fact, this past weekend, we got several amazing photographs of objects right around us in the field and overhead. And I think that what that's, you know, of course, it was too much to put in this short film series. And I think the director thought some of this stuff was a little too way out there. But because this, you know, the whole film is his take as someone who knows nothing about the subject. So it was quite a learning curve for him. But what I tell people is that the next thing I want to put out there is going to be on what you're discovering with these giant probable ET beings in Sardinia and elsewhere.